Now, the News 8 Storm Team forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Very dreary Monday out there. Luckily, we're not getting any real heavy rains. Nowhere close to what we had last Thursday into last Friday morning. Temperatures are going to stay in the low 50s for the rest of the day today. Periods of rain, feeling kind of raw out there, a little breezy and cool too. As we go through the evening, still pretty much the same thing. The only difference is temperatures drop a couple more degrees. Then as we head into the overnight hours, temperatures drop a couple more degrees. But the steadier rain is going to be tapering off to just kind of some on and off showers. But it remains cool and damp. There'll be a low ceiling. There'll be some patchy fog. Lows will be in the mid to upper 40s. And take a look at what happened to temperatures. This is at midnight as the rain was starting to come on in. That's basically when we had the high temperatures for the day in terms of the 24-hour period. Then the air kept on cooling down into the upper 40s by, you know, just at the tail end of the morning rush hour. We've only gone up a couple more degrees, and that's all they're going to do the rest of the afternoon. Here's the way it looks right now in the Capitol. Of course, you know, we see plenty of cloudy skies out there, lots of damp weather, and more rain coming on in for the rest of the afternoon. On the live Super Doppler Radar Network, most of the steadier rain now in terms of accumulation is in parts of Perry and Mifflin and Juniata counties, also near Mifflin County. Everything else is really pretty much just light at the current time. In fact, light rain at Harrisburg International Airport, 50 degrees. And the air is almost saturated, the relative humidity at 94%. Winds are out of the northwest right now at around 13 miles per hour. This storm system is basically an area of low pressure which is cutting itself off from the jet stream, and it's kind of redeveloped off the eastern seaboard, and it's just sending this, you know, these waves of Atlantic moisture our way, as opposed to last week, which was all tropical moisture. And at first we had the strong northeasterly winds. We had dry air at the surface and all that moisture mixing in with that dry air basically cooled the atmosphere. Eventually, high pressure will win out. The northwesterly winds will really start to take over and dry us out. But it's going to literally take a couple more days for that to happen because the pattern over North America is kind of blocked right now. So let's put our predictor into motion. And boom, you see the clouds with us. You see the light rain and drizzle kind of becoming more of a showery pattern as we go through tonight and all the way into Wednesday as well. We're still going to have some lingering showers. Then high pressure will start to move in, start to dry us out. A weak cold front will go through on Thursday with very little fanfare. In fact, after this, temperatures start warming back up to more seasonable levels. So more cool weather for tonight with the rain continuing down into the 40s. High temperatures tomorrow, once again, only in the 50s. It's not until Wednesday that we have another chance of getting back up to near 60 degrees. And we're finally back up to around 70 degrees, give or take a few, by Thursday into Friday. And right now, looking like a pretty nice dry weekend starting to set up. What did I say about rainy days and Mondays?
Yeah, I know. Good day to stay in bed or something, right?
And we don't need the rain anymore after last week.
All right. Yeah. We'll get through it. All right, Matt.